All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to be doing a selection, again, over a period of time, on DJ lessons for mobile DJs. I'm going to be calling them mobile mixing. Now, first thing is very important. People seem to think that if you're a DJ, whatever DJ you are, you've got to mix. You know, if you can't mix, you're not a DJ. If you can't put two tracks together, you're not a DJ. If you can't beat match them for eight bars, you're not a DJ.
It's like your shit if you can only like chop it from one to the other, you're crap.
That's rubbish, because being a DJ is about just playing music, but of course you have to maybe try and keep it in time, time signature, same sort of BPM, most of the time, not all the time, same BPM. You have to have some form of flow. Now, in this selection of videos, what I'm going to be doing is explaining a little bit more about what a mobile DJ will do. Now, anyone who is a mobile DJ or who has been a mobile DJ for a long time will pretty much tell you that they do not continually mix all night. You don't do that. If you're a club DJ, you probably do. If you're a house DJ, you probably do. They want to hear your mixing and the transitions and the smooth, this, that, and the other. When you're a mobile DJ, it's about playing the music. The main thing is about having good transitions, making sure that the key, the feel is the same. So I've got a demo here. We've got a hip hop track and we've got a really old school track. Now there's a couple of ways how I can chop these in. How a mobile DJ would chop them in. The first one is pretty simple and straightforward. The second one is a little bit more interesting, slightly more difficult, and you have to use your ear. Because when we're dealing with a band, of course, when a band plays a proper drummer, keyboard, guitarist, singer, they're not necessarily in time all the time. They could be slightly off, so the track could maybe start at 120. Within 3 seconds, it could be 120.2. Within 5 seconds after that, which after the 3 seconds, which is 8 seconds, it could be 120.3. So it's not perfect BPM all the time, because you're having a drummer, a real person, playing the drums, trying to act like a metronome, which is very difficult. So the second mix will be slightly more difficult. So what I'm going to do is give you a bit of a demo. So here we go, we'll wang that down there. And two tracks. So, right. Now first of all, this one here, this by the way, LYNYRD Skynyrd, Sweet Home Chicago. And if you don't know that one, then I'm afraid, where have you been for the past like 50 million years? Okay, so. And I promise you this time, I will put the names in the description. Now, the first thing a mobile DJ would do is listen. If they want to somehow have some sort of smooth transition, they'll listen to the track they're bringing in. Also, listen to the track that's playing and try and find a suitable place in the track that's playing where they can bring the track that they want to bring in into the track that's playing. This is the key.
One,
so,
two, three.
All right, now we could bring one, two, three. Now you notice, have a listen again, there was no four. Why not? The timing was still there. There was a gap where they would have said four. Have a listen.
One, two, three.
I'm gonna bring it in that bam bam.
One, two, three.
What? So. Alright, again, you know, this is playing through. Let's imagine, you know, the crowd are jumping around, eating bananas, and.
Sometimes your words just hypnotize me, and I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken yourself in. Can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me, and I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken yourself
Now, I just did a quick smooth one to the other. Why did I do a little bit of a spin back? Because I'm quite sure there's a point at which we get more vocals in, more rap, and I didn't want to sort of chop that up. I'll do exactly the same thing again. This time, I won't do a spin back. Here we go. I think it's this point. Bear with me.
Biggie, Biggie, can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me, and I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so mean.
Oh, no, it isn't. It's at the end anyway. Sorry. Right. No, we still are. No, I'll carry on. Hold on. I'll
just hypnotize me, and I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so mean. Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me, and I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so
mean. Yeah, we have the upper... So I would have, if I'd have brought it in there, I'd have had that. I put in, I'll give you a demo. Here we go.
Good.
Not back far enough. You see, we go, I put, bam. All right. So that is one way a mobile DJ should do it, because we have not only timing, they are keys that work well together, and also there's a nice bit of continuity. The more difficult way of doing it would be something like this. So we'll go back to the end.
Sometimes your words just hypnotize me, and I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so mean. Sometimes your words just hypnotize me, and I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so mean.
Now you'll notice there was a lot of movement down there. It's because they're possibly, again, this is a very quick demo. I haven't listened to the beginning of that, where, let's say, I haven't listened to make sure it's in perfect timing, but what I tried to do then was more of a smoother transition, all right? Now again, this is another way how mobile DJs will do mixing. It isn't a continual BPM mix, like so smooth for 16 or 18 bars. It is on the odd occasion, but more than likely, a mobile DJ, when they are mixing tracks of different genres and styles, they'll chop and try and do a smoother, more shorter transition. Hope that's been a help. Practice and enjoy. I do.